Hi everyone, it's Louisa. Welcome to Unlock to the show that decodes companies. Today, I welcome Geneviève and Reda from Vinci Energy, and we'll talk about the Young Talent Day, which is a digital event to get your end of studies internship. So, how to participate and prepare yourself for this event? How will they support you during your internship? Or what about the company's culture? Geneviève and Reda will tell you everything about that event and even more. Hi Geneviève. Hi Reda.
Hi.
Hi.
How
Hi,
are you?
Everyone.
Thanks for asking. I'm doing well.
So, to present you, Geneviève, you are HR officer.
Correct.
And Reda, you are oil and gas cybersecurity engineer.
Yes, exactly.
Geneviève, you know your next challenge. You will have to pitch Vinci Energy in less than 130 minutes. Are you ready?
I'm ready to go.
When you want.
Okay. So a few words about Vinci Energies. Our main goal, helping our customers all over the world facilitate and accelerate major transformations. Four business lines: infrastructure, industry, building, solution, ICT, which could be interesting for the future trainees, about 84,000 employees around the world. So the idea is that we support our customers by delivering increasingly innovative solutions and services, ranging from design to implementation, operation, and maintenance. Our commitments, serving people and taking care of the planet, focusing on environment, ethics, health and safety, key role in the civil society through one of our core values. More about this value later on.
Congratulations, Geneviève. You did it in less than 130 minutes. You succeed.
Great. I've done it.
So we are here to speak about the Young Talents Day. So Geneviève, can you tell us more about that event? What's the Young Talent Day?
Sure. So what is a very innovative, it's 100% digital and immersive experience spread in two sessions. The dates, the 13th and 14th of October, hours 4 to 7 p.m. And important, the deadline, you have until the 3rd of October to apply. After that, you will have to wait for next year, I'm afraid. So prepare CVs.
And Reda, right after, you will give us your tips because you have participated to this event last year. But Geneviève, can you tell us how to participate to this program? And also, what's the onboarding process?
Okay. So this year, we have more than 370 internships to fill. So what you have to do is, of course, send your CV and a video, very important, to see how you can introduce yourself in a very short time. Mm-hmm. It's about 30 seconds, but I think Reda will tell us more about it. So the idea, quick screening. A few tips, though. What is interesting on the CV? In my opinion, less is more. So essential information, professional experience, assignments, keywords, soft and hard skills, courses linked with the internship, and personalize your CV according to the job position. My top tip.
And you were speaking about a video presentation. You told me that this is not mandatory, but Reda, what are your tips to create a successful video presentation?
Well, I made it last year. So first, you should note that this is only a 2 minutes video. So the candidates have to be efficient on that exercise. For the content of the video, you should start by introducing yourself and explaining why you want to make this internship at Vinci Energies. So you can justify it to your professional and volunteering experiences or even your courses. The objective here is to catch the recruiter attention and demonstrate your motivations. And to make the video, you don't need to be a professional in video editing. To be honest with you, it was not my case last year. You just have to make it in good conditions. I mean, making the video in front of a white wall, for example, speak loudly, And most importantly, play on the body language to show your dynamism. And of course, being natural. So this exercise should be taken seriously because it's the first impression you leave to the recruiters.
And you told me you do not have to spend too much time on the presentation, but focus on your motivations, right?
Yes, exactly.
That's the most important. And Reda, what's the imperative criteria to participate to this event online when they apply?
Well, quite simply, you have to apply to an offer and be shortlisted in order to receive an invitation to participate to the Young Talents Days. And of course, you can apply to several offers if you want.
And you also told me that when you were preparing those interviews, you did not was aware about the branding system. So this is
yes.
One of your requirements?
Yes, exactly. And I learned more about it during the Young Talents Day.
Yeah. So this is your tips, learn more about the branding
yes.
system.
Yes. So, yes, exactly. Personalize your experience during the Young Talents Day to have more information about the company, because at first I was a bit lost with the decentralized approach of the company and about the branding systems too.
And Jadiev, can you tell us more about what kind of profiles are you looking for?
So mainly profiles in engineering schools, management, business, IT, end of studies, internships, mainly, I think. And the idea, yes, we have four business lines. So these are a sum up because we have different businesses, but the main profiles we are looking for are those.
And Reda, just before you told us that you learned more about the branding system mm-hmm. during that day, during the Young Talents Day, mm-hmm. but to have an overview of that day, can you tell us concretely how does it work?
So clearly, when you are shortlisted, as I said before, you will receive an invitation. So this is a link to a platform. So you will find yourself in a virtual hall. And it is up to the candidate to personalize their experience so mm-hmm. they can have the opportunity to attend conferences and pitch led by Vinci Energy's employees. So this can be on different topics such as a presentation of the group, energy transition, digital transformation. And also, and candidate will also have the opportunity to exchange with employees. They are very available, and it's very important to exchange with them to have more information. And to be honest, the platform is very ergonomic. It is not really possible to get lost. So if you're looking for a particular place or have another question, just ask it directly in the chat and someone will answer directly. So that's fairly intuitive.
And can you tell us more about your own experience? What about last year?
To be honest, I really enjoyed my experience because, as I told before, I was lost with the decentralized approach of Vinci Energies, but I exchanged with many employees of the group, and right now I know very well the organization of the company, so it was a very good experience. And about my interview, I made it with my business manager with the application of the platform.
And what about what about the atmosphere during that day?
People are nice. Everyone is available, so no problem with that.
You told me that it was very, you can answer questions. It was very caring people. That's
yes,
what you
exactly.
felt during that day.
Yes.
And Geneviève, you had also participated to this event last year as an HR. What are your tips to optimize that day?
I think my top tip would be just be yourself. Try to see the interview as an informal conversation. We are just trying to get more about each other, to know more about each other. Try to test the platform and the connection before logging on, and feel free to ask your questions whatever they may be.
Yeah.
I think it's a real opportunity to have a chance, just as Red Hat told us earlier, it's a great opportunity to know more about the Vinci Energies structure and way of managing, etc. So
yes, there are no taboo questions, seriously.
Yeah. And that's why when we were preparing that interview, you told me I will recommend the candidates to arrive before and stay after the interview to see more contents and learn more about the group.
Exactly.
Reda, as you experience it, how will the trainees be supporting during their internship? What about your own experience?
Okay, so about my own experience in the oil and gas division, my business manager was also my internship tutor. He was very available and it enabled me to work easily on my missions. And for my integration in the oil and gas division, there was a person from the human resources who was in charge of the integration of the trainees. So she was in charge of helping us to get our computer tools the first week, for example, and to introduce us to the employees. Mm-hmm. And in addition, she organized some events. For example, the first one was about the presentation of the company. The second one was about to get to know the other interns better. And finally, there was a day where the trainees introduced themselves and the progress of their mission to the different managers of the division. So it's a kind of networking event that allows us to be recruited after our internship. Sorry.
And there's also an IT point where they can give you your computers and.
Yes, it was the first tools. Week by the IT manager.
Okay, and. Also, you told me something, I guess, really important. You told me in the oil and gas department, it requires to travel a lot.
Yeah,
and you have the opportunity to go abroad.
Yes, I was deployed in Abu Dhabi for 2 months. It was a very good experience because I was involved on a cybersecurity project. So it was very concrete.
And you, Geneviève, you work in Belgium. Can you give us your HR point of view on it?
Sure. So I think the aim of the internships is certainly to attract the right people. Mm-hmm. And what I mean by that is we have values and five core values. And I think it's important that the candidate matches the values. So I think this is it. We have one of them, which is entrepreneurship. So we have to be extra careful when preparing the topic. So if you want to attract innovative people, entrepreneurs, you have to be good at building up interesting topics. But here it's about my experience in Belgium. But each business unit has its own DNA. So, but the idea is the same. We've just heard Reda. So you have a supervisor. We have to make sure that this person is available. So mm-hmm. one other very important point is to choose an available supervisor. Then the idea is to... that the intern has a great time, enjoys himself or herself, and then stays with us, because it's from my experience and my point of view, those ex-interns are really people that are less stressed on their first day. So it's a chance to get to know your team, to see some kind of reality check, let's say. So then the idea, if it's a match in both ways, we keep this person, and then you have to decide when this new recruit will start with us. And then there is an onboarding program, which in Belgium lasts 6 months. Okay. And you have some HR follow-up as well as an interview with the business unit manager to make sure that this person is at the right place and mm-hmm. can tell us if something is if he or she has questions. We are always available to listen to our people.
And you mm-hmm. told us that each business unit has its own DNA, but yeah. globally, and you already speak about the Vinci Energies value. Can you tell us more about those values?
Sure. So we have five core values, which are autonomy, responsibility, entrepreneurship, confidence, trust, let's say, solidarity. And those, yes, we could say, okay, it's just, those are just words or it's just yeah. a motto, but it really makes sense both before hiring someone and then on a daily basis working on a different project, whatever job you do within the Vinci Energies group, those are really the core values. It's not something that we say and then we don't do what we say. It's really part of it.
And earlier we were speaking about young graduates integration. Jean-Jacques, mm-hmm. can you tell us what's the kind and what type of management within Vinci Energies? What about your...
So if yes, I would say it's a flat management structure. So it's true, being autonomous is the key, but you also have to be a team player. And being an entrepreneur, so the idea of entrepreneurship is that if you have an idea which could bring some more business, feel free to speak to the project manager, to the business unit manager, really be part of it. And if we have to, I've already told you about it, but when I perform the HR interview, so I really pay attention to that, because if we have the perfect CV with all the technology we are looking for, and this person seems to be the perfect match, but then mm-hmm. when we talk about being a team player or being responsible and they don't fit, then I will decide maybe it's not such a good match at all.
So soft skills and hard skills yeah. are a good point, mm-hmm. but they need to match with your values.
Yeah, absolutely.
Are you okay with that, Reda? And can you tell us more about your management experience also?
Yes, but about the type of management, I agree with Geneviève. It's a kind of participative management. I mean, employees are invited to share in the decision-making process of the firm by participating in activities such as setting goals and making suggestions. I really had this feeling during my mission, especially in Abu Dhabi.
And what about your own career path? You told me that you were creating projects.
Yes, right. Because we are a new business unit, so mm-hmm. in the cybersecurity, so we began to create new projects. I was recruited because I have a specialization in cybersecurity, so my business manager trusted on me enough to let me make proposition about creation of project in cybersecurity. So the values of the company are clearly respected.
So entrepreneur, autonomy, confidence, that's exactly. a huge part of your culture. As we're speaking about companies' cultures, and Jeff, what about the internal trainings, maybe to help them to become entrepreneur?
Yes. So I will try to explain it so that it matches almost every business unit, because it's very local sometimes. So there is an academy within the group which offers training. So those could be soft skill trainings or hard skills training sometimes. So what is common is that, for instance, those trainings about corruption, bribery, ethics, in other words, and those are usually mandatory, and you have a flow which indicates to the employee what training he should join, he or she should join. And of course, during the appraisal, we have an annual appraisal with your, let's say, with your manager. And it's also the perfect time to discuss the future trainings, such as, I don't know, if we lack some knowledge or skills, it could be a nice opportunity to join some training. But it also could be about how to become a better person, or to become better at what you do. So some working points that could be strengthened by some training. So it's being trained within our company is really not a problem at all.
And that's a solution. So a trainee can participate to one of those trainings program when they arrive in the company? That's possible for a trainee to participate to one of those programs?
Okay.
Yes, we can. Yeah. Yes, we can. But yeah, it's a little bit restricted compared to someone on a full-time position. But we have access to some training, of course.
Okay. And to continue on the values, do you have any social commitments?
Sure. So the value that would reply to this that would match this social commitment would certainly be solidarity. So Initiative Cœur is one of our most known initiatives and projects. The idea is financing surgeries for children with heart disease. And there is some communication within the company, so via emails, but also on Facebook and the social media. So we know what is going on regarding this project. So there is a regular communication on this particular project.
Reda, do you want to add something regarding this?
Yes, and about the environment, VINCI Energies wants also to limit the impact of our business on the environment. So they created, for example, the Environment Pricey, which is a competition where employees can submit projects related to the environment. And the project that wins the Environment Award is chosen and funded next. So everyone can participate. The interns cannot participate the first year because the beginning of their internship is after the starting of the Environment Pricey, but they can participate to the vote, which is
all right.
Good.
Good, yeah. Do you have a last word, something that you would like to add regarding the Young Talents Day or the company's culture?
Be natural and join VINCI Energies.
Geneviève, do you have a last word?
Yes, as I said earlier, less is more, so simply come and meet us.
Thank you very much for sharing your company's culture and also all your tips for the Young Talents Day. At home, if you want to apply, you can directly go to their website, vincienergie.com. Thank you very much, both of you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Lisa. It was a pleasure.
And see you very soon for a new live. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.